Okay, YouTube, I think that's going to work. Got both bearing cups in, and put my spacer on the outside there. We got clearance on the cranks on both sides there. We can swing over here. Took the pedal off of that side, but you can see we've got that much clearance there. Let's go take a look at the other side. So there we go on that side. Yeah, about the same, maybe a little more. I think it'll come in a bit as I tighten everything down. Yeah, so I went with the anodized red color because I've also got the, you can see in the cassette, I've got the red anodized on the carrier in the middle, and the rest of the cassette's silver. So I thought that would look kind of nice, get a little touch of a different color up there. So yeah, I'll show you what it looks like. I'll take it apart here and we'll show you what all the pieces look like. Okay, there's the spindle sticking out. You can see without the spacers you get quite a bit of shaft. So now I have the crank clearanced out there about 5 mils deeper than it used to be. And then to make up the outside of the splines there, I made that little spacer. And then you have this piece goes in there and pushes the spacer against the outside of the crank. Yeah, make some measurements here. I just want to make sure everything's being pushed together properly. I'll do some measurements and check everything out. Yeah, I think that's a handy solution right there. Just a little spacer, 24 millimeter inner diameter to fit over the splines, and then 28 millimeter outer diameter, 2 millimeter thick walls. It's solid ABS plastic, so that should be plenty strong. Yeah, I'll show you there's the recess that it goes into there, right around the splines. Yeah, let me do some measuring and then we'll figure out if that's the final part or if I have to make a change to it, and we'll put it all together. Yeah, so one other part I forgot to mention is this is the tube that goes in between the two bottom bracket bearing shells. And this is the original one that came with my Shimano bottom bracket. Yeah, so this is what I came up with on this part. It turns out there's a ring that's thicker and then it's got the thinner tube in the middle. You can just cut those free and then it collapses down as short as you want. So I think what I'm going to do is before I put this together, I'll just put a little adhesive in there, set it out wide, and then when I press it down, it'll probably press down to about that point, and that'll fill up the gap in there. So I think that's all I need to do there. Yeah, so here's the new spacer that came with the new bottom bracket. You can see it's about a little over 57 millimeters. Now I'm running three spacers less. If I run that about 50 millimeters, that should be the correct spacing, and I think that'll work. So I'm just gonna glue this up about 50 millimeters and then shove it in there. That'll be my new spacer. So that's how much I've narrowed the bottom bracket. You can see right there, that's how wide it used to be and that's how wide it's gonna be. Okay, there we go, YouTube. Got the crank all back together. I think that's going to work out. Got clearance on the chain stays, same on each side. So down here, I checked the clearance or the space between my spacer and the bearing, and I think that came out to be about 23 millimeters, and the width of the crank is about 24 millimeters. So that tells me that I have enough extra thickness in the spacer to push the crank all the way into the bearing, which I guess is what you have to do. But yeah, that works pretty good. So you just need to trim about 5 millimeters of the splines out of the inside of the crank, pull out your spacers from behind the bearings, and then add a 5 millimeter spacer on the outside, and that can push it in. And now I've got a narrower Q factor. Okay, if we zoom in there, I have the scale set on the other side. I think I'm right at 170 millimeters. So that's the what's called the Q factor, is the distance from the outside of one crank to the outside of the other crank. So I think that's about all I'm going to get there. Can't go any narrower. I imagine the road cranks have a straighter side on them than the mountain bike cranks, but if they're too straight, they're going to hit the chainstays. That is probably about as good as I'm going to do, and I need the mountain bike cranks because I need the smallest ring on the triple crank there, and I think that's about as good as you're going to do. But yeah, we'll see how that works. I'll give you an update if there's any noticeable change. Otherwise, I think it'll just do what I expect it to do. If you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.